querying a database. In the previous lecture, we created a database. We created the database structure, which included creating the tables, creating the fields, the field properties and field types, creating the relationships, and enforcing referential data integrity between the tables. After we created the database, then we actually input information into our database. Now, databases are designed to store huge amounts of information. And many times, you don't need all of that information. You just want to display a view or a subset of that information. You can do that by using something called a query. A query is a request for information from your database. To extract the information from the database, you have to use a query, which is the question or request. Many times, the query will consist of a criteria. The criteria is an expression that tells the database management system which records to retrieve, and it's made up of conditions. When you run the query, a dynaset or subset of the database is displayed. You can make changes to the dynaset, and the changes will be reflected in your dataset because the dynaset is just a view of your database. Microsoft Access has a GUI, a graphical user interface tool, that allows you to create queries without having to know the programming language to do it. The GUI, or the graphical user interface used by Access, is called the Query by Example Grid, or the QBE grid. The QBE grid will show the client list, or the tables, in this case it's the client table, and then you can put on the grid the fields that you want to display. When you create the grid and you run it, a dynaset is created for you and displayed for you to look at in your database. For example, here's the research papers database that we talked about in the previous lecture. I'm going to click on the Create button. There is a Query Wizard and a Query Design tool. The Query Wizard will step you through the queries. We will use the Query Design tool because we will be using or completing more advanced queries. I'm going to use the Client table. I'm going to show you this in detail later. For now, I just want to show you an example. I click on Add, I click on Close. Here is my QBE grid. I want to display the first name, and I want to display the last name. So I have this database table that has all of these fields in it, but all I want to display right now is the first name and the last name. I just want a view of my database. So I go up to the red exclamation point and I click on Run. When I click on Run, my dynaset or my subset of data is displayed. Remember, this is a view of my database. Now, if I go to this dynaset and I change John Smith to John Jones, and I close it, and I save the query, and I'm going to name this query Client List. You could name it anything you want, just make it self-describing, and I click OK. Then I click on the Client table, and John Smith has been changed to John Jones. I can go to the table, and I can change John Jones back to John Smith. I can close, and when I double-click on the query to run it, now the record has changed again. This client list, again, is just a view of my database. When we use the QBE grid to create our queries, there is a programming language that is created for us called SQL, or SQL, or Structured Query Language. SQL is a language that is used to talk to the database. Microsoft Access creates the SQL for you when you use the QBE grid. If you are a programmer type, when you are writing programs, you will use SQL embedded in your program to interact with the database. So, for example, in this easy query that we created, let's look at the SQL that was created. I clicked on Home, I click on View, I clicked on SQL View, and there is the SQL that was created. And that is a programming language that you have to use to interact with a database. And again, it has syntax that you have to follow, so it's nice that it's created for you. And again, there is the SQL that was created from your QBE grid. And this is a good way to learn SQL if you need to learn it. Create the queries, run the queries, and view the SQL. And then you can examine the SQL code to understand exactly what it is, what task it's performing.